a very nice phone call from David Fox. And David called to say congratulations. He said he looks forward to working together and moving forward with Nashville, and that's who we are, and that's what we'll do. You know, tonight we start a new chapter of Nashville, of the Nashville story. And that story is the saga that is written every day by the people in this room and those of you who are watching at home. This story is written by the Nashvillians, who are our entrepreneurs, our small business owners, who take those risks and find those solutions to old problems. And they need a mayor who will help recruit and retain the talent so that Nashville can energize and reach our full potential. This story is going to be written by the artists, the musicians, the entertainers who inspire all of us. These creatives need a mayor who is going to support the artistic community and make sure that Nashville stays affordable. This story is being written by our teachers who dedicate their lives every day to educate our children. And our teachers need a mayor who is going to stand by them and support them and continue to educate everyone. And this story is being written by our police officers and our firefighters, especially our firefighters, woo, who put their lives on the line all the time to make sure that Nashville is a safe place. Our police and our firefighters need a mayor who will make sure that promises made are promises kept.
That's it, that's it, yeah!
But this is really a story about our working families. And those families who are the backbone of our economy, who need access to transportation, excellent public education, and affordable places to live. Our working families need a mayor who is going to create prosperity for everyone. And then there's the chapter that we're writing today.
All right.
You, the Nashville voters.
Yes.
This one is going to go down in the history books. This one is all about the fact that today you went to the polls and you elected the first woman. Tonight. We have our challenges, and I need you to help me write the next chapter of Nashville. We have to make sure that while tonight we are celebrating victory, and it is so nice to celebrate victory tonight, it's the result of the fact that all of the Nashvillians who came out today were above the fray. And they made the right choice. And I did not get here alone. Nobody does. I am here with all of these people behind me and in front of me who are responsible for my victory tonight. There are too many to thank individually, but I do have to single a few people out. That starts with my husband, Bruce. My husband has been a saint, and he has bitten his tongue a lot. Our son Max, who is off at college and could not be here tonight, my parents who are behind me somewhere, who instilled in me the value of hard work, honesty, truthfulness, dedication, and those are the values that will go with me into the mayor's office. Governor Phil Bredesen, I have to shout out to him. He gave our campaign a critical boost at the very beginning of this race. And Howard Gentry, who stands behind me. Howard, who stood with me against those negative attacks and was an inspiration to the community of Nashville, as he always has been and will continue to be. And Charles Robert Bone, who became a close friend on the campaign trail and has become an even closer friend and advisor in these past few weeks. Lee Walton, my treasurer.
Yes.
Her name is on everything, and she made that commitment to me at the very beginning, and she has been a tireless advocate for me in my campaign. My kitchen cabinet of advisors, many of whom are here tonight, who have helped steer my campaign. My campaign staff, you are amazing. Claudia Husky, who has been so incredible. And my communications director, Sean Braystead. The two people I brought on at the very beginning who have been so critical. But all of my staff has been amazing. And finally, you. You, my friends, my volunteers, you all knocked thousands of doors. You made thousands of phone calls. You put up over 10,000 signs. Thank you very much. And last, but certainly not least, the voters of Nashville. That is who brought it home tonight. And that is who is writing this story. Tomorrow, our real work begins. But this is a job I hope I've been preparing for the last 8 years, because I get to walk into that office and I actually know how it works.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
But I can't do this without you. I cannot do this without all of you. So here is my ask. In the weeks, the months, and the years to come, we all have to work together.
Right.
We all have to lift up Nashville.
Yeah.
We all have to be in this same place, rowing in the same direction, because that is how we will continue to make Nashville a great place for everyone. And Nashvillians, I believe